So the whip. The whip is what I use for an accent, for an accent. That's what that looks like. So let me slow it down so you can see it. Well, think of it. Think of it at three different points. You have a pivot point at the shoulder, and you have a pivot point at the elbow, and you have a pivot point at the wrist. So the first pivot point we begin with at the shoulder, which let's just pick the elbow out. Moving the elbow out immediately brings our angle on our forearm and sets our hand higher. And then we throw the elbow in, which picks the forearm up and snaps the wrist into its upright position, in the full stroke position. And then continue with your momentum on the way down, and that's added to the wrist stroke plus the downward motion of the forearm with the momentum of the whip of the elbow behind it. So very slowly is what it looks like. Like that. I'm leading with my elbow and then sending the motion of the elbow through my arm and through my wrist. So really what I'm doing is just adding this extra momentum and motion to what my wrist is already doing. So I'm using my wrist here. And I can add my arm to it. If I time my elbow properly, put a metronome on now. Your left side looks this way. I'm not using any pressure. Just the speed of the stick from the momentum and the extra mass of my arm and the extra height that I'm getting out of the arc because of the momentum behind it. It's just creating a louder sound. So let me do a one-to-one with the metronome. Has a rhythm. Of course, the rhythm depends on the tempo. But if I speed the tempo up, then my rhythm becomes different. I have less time to work up the momentum. So it happens in a shorter span of time, in a shorter distance in space. Now if I add strokes to this, in between, I can get into one stroke in between, I'm subdividing it. And now you can see the difference. They're both wrist strokes, except one has an additional mass and momentum added to it. Thank you. is a harmonic progression of subdivision. The reason I say that is because it has a vertical viewpoint that amount of time. They will have a relationship to each other in the same amount of space of time. So so the more notes I put in, the higher the subdivision, then the faster the speed gets within the same period of time. But there's another way to do it, where you can use a linear way of subdividing, where you extend the space of time to make the subdivision look phrase instead of using a harmonic relationship from a vertical standpoint. So for that, now let me show you how that would work. Let's put the metronome up to a good warm tempo. And just play half strokes. This is the way I was doing it originally, right? So now I'm speeding up the tempo quite a bit. An octave above. And now we're coming up above, an octave above that. And instead of speeding up on the subdivision, we're going to keep tempo where the eighth note is the same. Never stops. I'm just, you know, adding the whip in, and I'm trying to time the beginning of the momentum before the wrist stroke that I wanted to make an accent with add to.